We've been a leader in banking for more than 100 years. You'll find us here, at home, on your phone, and everywhere you go. Renaissance Bank. Understanding you. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Sponsored by Renaissance Bank.
Good morning and welcome to Daily Journal Newsbreak, sponsored by Renaissance Bank. Today is Wednesday, August 8th, and I'm your host, Elizabeth Walters. We're going to take a look at today's top news and sports stories across Northeast Mississippi, but first, let's start with your weather forecast. Today we'll have partly cloudy skies with scattered thunderstorms later tonight, have a high of 92 and a low of 72, and chance of rain is at 60%. And over the next 3 days, on Thursday we'll have a few thunderstorms possible with a high of 86 and a low of 71. Friday, scattered thunderstorms with a high of 89 and a low of 71. And on Saturday, partly cloudy skies with a high of 91 and a low of 71. Now let's take a look at today's top headlines. The future of Tupelo's Main Street is being discussed this week, with the public giving input on what they'd like to see downtown. The Downtown Tupelo Main Street Association received a $3,000 grant to bring in a revitalization expert and hold meetings this week to brainstorm ideas for a downtown transformation. And this included Tuesday night's meeting with local business owners. The Main Street Association sent out a survey last month to determine its priorities for revitalization and had almost 400 people responding. The answers of those who surveyed showed crime, entertainment, and homelessness were the top three biggest issues facing the community. And they mentioned they would like to see more breweries, entertainment, restaurant options, and art opportunities downtown. Program Associate Reagan Pepper said event evaluation, attracting and keeping businesses, and promoting diversity in the downtown area were voted as the top priorities during Tuesday's meetings. The Board of Directors will meet today to review strategies for transforming the downtown area. And Tupelo City Council voted unanimously Tuesday night to approve a resolution requesting two things of the state legislature. The resolution asked the legislature to require all online retailers to collect sales tax on purchases and that municipalities like Tupelo receive a share of those taxes. Mayor Jason Shelton said over 50% of Tupelo's budget relies on sales tax revenue, and the city has significantly benefited in recent years from a thriving retail sector. In June, the U.S. Supreme Court reversed its own ruling that states could not require online retailers to collect sales tax except in states where that retailer had a physical presence. The new ruling opens the door for a state to require that sales tax be collected on all online purchases made within the state. Several pieces of legislation involving online sales tax were considered in the most recent session of the legislature, but none became law. And the latest ruling by the U.S. Supreme Court came after the session's end. The City Council is now asking Governor Bryant to call a special session so that the legislature can pass such legislation. And new figures show that Saltillo's switch from well water to river water will cost more and take longer than originally expected. When the city approved the switch in July, the estimated cost of connecting all of the city's customers to the Northeast Mississippi Regional Water Supply District was around $114,000. During its Tuesday night meeting, they learned that the new estimate is closer to $123,000, and they'll have to spend another $46,000 to make sure a water tower does not overfill. And before the city can switch water sources, the Mississippi Department of Health must review and approve plans, which could take several weeks. In addition, Saltillo has to advertise for bids to reconnect to the water district and install an 8-inch water meter to serve the eastern side of the city, and that could add at least 3 more months to the process. Residents west of U.S. 45 could be switched back now, but Mayor Rex Smith is against that approach, saying they need to make sure they're doing this right and only do it once. While the Alderman did move forward with some aspect of the switch, they are waiting on more information. During Tuesday night's meeting, they did not approve the contract from the water district or approve advertising for bids for the new connection and water meter. And in sports, Mississippi State women's basketball leaves today for a 10-day tour of Italy and will play 3 exhibition games against international competition. The Bulldogs will first play in Rome against Deep 3 Select on Saturday before traveling to Florence to play TK Hanover on Monday, and they'll conclude the trip in Venice against International Select on August 16th. In conjunction with the trip, State will receive 10 additional practices, which will help head coach Vic Schaefer's squad with 6 newcomers. Schaefer said they are a young team but should be talented and good. He said that this opportunity gives the freshmen a chance to play together and extra practices together. And that does it for Newsbreak on this Wednesday. Don't forget that this show is just one of the many online offerings courtesy of the Daily Journal that gets you news off the page and on the go. Each story discussed today on Newsbreak can be found in your daily journal and online at djournal.com, where you can also find a new episode of Newsbreak each weekday morning. Thanks for joining us. I'm Elizabeth Walters. Have a great afternoon.